This is a video for our students who are studying in class 5. For those who have been admitted, who are new to the class, I'm Santosh Kumar, your assistant teacher, will be teaching you lesson number 2, human migration. Okay? The first lesson has been completed. Virendra Singh has taught you. That is why I'm starting second lesson. Okay? Human migration. Before I start, I would like to ask a few questions, my dear boys and girls. The first one is that can we fulfill all our needs sitting at a place? Means, if I'm sitting over here, can I fulfill my all needs? Can I eat food that I want sitting over here? Can I do my job? Can I find water sitting over here without moving any other place? So, student, we can't do that, okay? We need to move. We need to move from one place to another place. Actually, the movement of human beings from one place to another to satisfy different needs is migration. Okay? Migration in Hindi is called pravas. Migration in Hindi is called pravas. I have written the definition of migration. Okay? Migration is the systematic, regular movement of people from one place to another. In simple language, migration is nothing but the movement of people from one place to another. Okay, my dear boys and girls, let me make you understand. Migration is not a new thing. It used to happen in past also. Okay, actually, human beings could not have survived without migrating. Okay, mankind and migration, I have written a line here. Mankind and migration had been linked to each other. Okay, if human beings had not migrated, they could not have survived. Even today, if we do not migrate, we people will not be able to survive. Okay? To satisfy different need, to fulfill our needs, we need to migrate. You may have read a chapter, Early Man. Okay? Early Man, you have studied in class 3, in which you saw that human beings in ancient times early human beings used to migrate from one place to another in search of food and water. Okay? Students, while studying human migration, you might have been wondering, you might be thinking that why people migrate, okay? Or why they used to migrate in past. They used to move in past in search of food and water or shelter. Okay, you know very well that early man were food gatherer in the beginning. They were just food gatherer. They used to hunt animals. They used to gather food, fruits, etc. Okay, but slowly they started growing crops and they became food producer, and they started leaving to the places where they were growing crops. Okay, that is how they started living a settled life. Okay, but still they had to move to transport different things, to take their food items from the places they used to grow to the places they were settling. Okay, so migration is very important. Okay, in ancient time, people used to migrate for food, water or shelter. Okay, even today, human beings migrate for different purposes. Look at your own family. There may be some people
in your homes, in your family, who are not living with you. They have migrated to different places for better job, education, health facilities, etc. Okay, your uncle, aunt, your brother, sister, your father might be leaving to different states for doing their job or for different purposes. So this is what? This is migration. This is migration. Okay. Students, since long videos can't be sent, I'm sending another video also. Watch this video first, thereafter I'm sending another. The new term that we need to learn about is shifting agriculture. Okay, another term that we need to learn about is shifting agriculture. Okay, shifting agriculture is also known as झूम की खेती in India. इसमें होता यह है कि जब तक एक पीस ऑफ लैंड को यानी एक ज़मीन के टुकड़े पे खेती की जाती है लंबे समय तक, जब तक ये फर्टाइल यानी उपजाऊ रहता है, क्रॉप्स अच्छे आते रहते हैं, जैसे ही क्रॉप्स अच्छे आने बंद हो जाते हैं, ज़मीन जो है कम उपजाऊ हो जाता है, तो उसमें फिर उस पीस ऑफ लैंड को छोड़ दिया जाता है और दूसरे जगह जाके खेती की जाती है। इस एग्रीकल्चरल प्रैक्टिस को हम लोग शिफ्टिंग एग्रीकल्चर कहते हैं। ओके, शिफ्टिंग एग्रीकल्चर इज अ प्रैक्टिस इन विच अ पीस ऑफ लैंड इज टिल ओके इज कल्टिवेटेड अ पीस ऑफ लैंड इज यूज फॉर कल्टिवेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ क्रॉप्स ओके टिल द सॉइल इज फर्टाइल एंड देन द पीस ऑफ लैंड इज लेफ्ट अबंडेंट एंड new piece of land is grown. Okay, here's the definition I have written. I want you people to write this definition and remember it, though many other types of cultivation will be taught to you in higher classes, but shifting cultivation, shifting agriculture is to be taught in class 5. That's why I have given definition, students. Okay, shifting cultivation, I'm repeating once again, shifting cultivation is a practice of growing crops on a piece of land till the soil is fertile. Thereafter, the piece of land is left abandoned and a new piece of land is grown. Okay? And new piece of land is used for growing crops. For growing crops. Okay, so you people might have understood what shifting agriculture is. Students, the topic that we are dealing with today is human migration. Okay, so migration, a question can be arisen that does migration happen only in human beings? No, migration happens in animals also. Animal also migrate for certain needs. Okay, animal migrate from one habitat to another habitat, one region to another region. Okay, but the purpose is a bit different from human beings. They need to move from one habitat to another habitat, one region to another region, for breeding, to grow. Okay, to find food and to avoid cold and hot weather. Okay, students, in Bihar, some Siberian cranes, okay, a kind of birds, come during the summer. Okay, in Siberia, when there is extreme cold, they migrate from there and come to India. Okay, in search of warm atmosphere, okay, where they can breed, and when they go back, they breed here, and when they go back, they go back with their newborn children, newborn offsprings. Okay, have you understood? So animal also, it's not that only human beings migrate, even animal migrate from one place to another, one region to another, but their purpose is a bit different from human beings. Okay, they move or they migrate for breeding, to grow, to find food, or to avoid cold and hot weather. Okay, I have just given you example of Siberian crane. They just try to avoid extreme situation that is found in Siberia. Okay, now I have written three terms, my dear students. Okay, first is migrant. Those who migrate are called migrant. Okay, pravasi. Migration means pravas, and migrant means pravasi. Okay, pravasi. Okay, pravasi. Okay, so those who migrate are called migrant. Okay, and the second is, if somebody is migrating from India to another country, okay, then that person who has migrated from India would be an emigrant for India, okay, and to the country he is migrating, he is an immigrant. Okay, I have written definition. Those who migrate to another place are emigrant for the place they left. They have left. Okay. And those who migrated to another place are immigrants for the new place they have migrated to. Okay. Let me make you understand. Student, suppose you happen to go America. Okay, for studies. Okay, for India you are an emigrant. Okay, and for America, the place you have migrated to, you are an immigrant. Spelling is E-M-I-G-R-A-N-T, means you have migrated from here, then you are emigrant of this place and you are immigrant of the place you have reached to. Okay, students, I want you people to write all these things and make a fair copy in a notebook. Okay, this is your homework. Make your homework. You need to learn these definitions because I will be taking a test of this lesson. Okay, tomorrow one more class will be conducted. In next week I would be conducting a test in which you people will have to write definition. Okay, and will have to send me the answers. Okay, I want you people to make a fair copy in beautiful handwriting. Okay, if you do not get anything, you can talk to me, you can send any message on WhatsApp. Okay, on 5 class group, there is a 5 class group WhatsApp group. Okay, you can send that. We'll be talking tomorrow. Thank you.